Hello my dear students, in this video we are starting with the civics portion lesson 2, the Indian executive. And in this lesson we will discuss about the official head of the country or official head of India and the official head of state. The president of India, he is the official head of the union or central executive. In a state level, governor is the official head. In the central level, president is the official head, and in the state level, governor is the official head. And what are the qualifications of these people? First one, he should be an Indian citizen and at least 35 years old. And he should be a qualified member of the lower house. These are the qualification. And the president of India, he is elected indirectly by an electoral college consisting of the elected MPs and MLAs. The president is elected by electoral college, that means MPs and MLAs. And the governor of a state is appointed by the president. Okay, and in some time one governor is appointed for more than one state. And what is the time limit or term of office of the president? The president is elected for a term of 5 years and he can be elected for a second term. And the official residence of the president is the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And the official residence of the governor is Raj Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan and Raj Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan is for Rashtrapati Bhavan is for president and Raj Bhavan is for governor. And what is the term of office? The president is elected for the term of 5 years. And now we will discuss about the legislative powers of the president. The president addresses the first session of the parliament after elections. President, he addresses the first session of parliament after the election. The state level, the governor addresses the first session of the state legislature. And the president, he summons or ends the session of the parliament. The governor summons and prorogues the sessions of the state legislature. And the third legislative power is the president, he can dissolve or dismiss the Lok Sabha, and the governor, he can dissolve the state legislative assembly. And fourth one, after the signature of the president only, a bill becomes a law in the state level after the signature of governor. And when the parliament is not in session, when the parliament is not in session, the president, he can issue an ordinance. The president can issue an ordinance when the parliament is not in the session. Okay, so once again we can revise what we have learned in this video. In this video we learned about the official head of the executive, the president of India. He is the official head of the union executive. In the state level, the governor is the official head. But these people are acts according to the advice of the council of ministers. And what is the qualification? He should be an Indian citizen, at least 35 years old, and he should be a qualified member of the lower house. And the president of India is elected directly by the electoral college consisting of the MPs and MLAs. And the governor selected or appointed by the president. And what is the term of office? The president is elected for a term of 5 years. And governor also is appointed for a term of 5 years. And what is the official residence? Rashtrapati Bhavan is the official residence of president. And Raj Bhavan is the official residence of governor. Okay, and what are the legislative powers of president and governor? The president, he addresses the first session of the parliament after election. The governor, he addresses the first session of the state legislature. And the president, he summons or ends the session of parliament in the state level, the governor is doing. And the president, he can dissolve or dismiss the Lok Sabha, and the governor, he can dissolve, dismiss the state legislative assembly. Then what was next? After the signature of governor or president, a bill become a law. And last one, when the parliament is not in the session, the president, he can issue an ordinance. Okay, these are the important legislative powers of the president. And what are the executive powers of president? Executive powers. All decisions of the union executive are carried out in the name of president. And all decisions of the state executive are carried out in the name of the governor. Union executive are taking decisions in the name of president, and the state level in the name of governor. And all the high ranking officials of the executive are appointed either by the president or by the governor. High ranking officials are appointed by the president. And what is the judicial power? The president, on an appeal for mercy, can reduce the sentence of grant pardon to any person sentenced by the court within Indian territory. He can even change a death sentence. That is the judicial power. Okay, that is a special power of the president. President, he can change a death punishment, death sentence. Okay, and the governor, he can grant pardon to or reduce the sentence of a person sentenced under the law of the state. Anyway, the governor, he cannot change a death sentence, but a president, he can even change a death sentence, but governor, he cannot change a death sentence. These are the official or judicial powers of the president. And what is the emergency powers of president? The president, on the advice of council of ministers, president is declaring general emergency. Advice of the council of ministers, the president, he is declaring emergency. And what are the situation for declaring emergency? An attack from outside, a disturbance within, or a financial crisis. During this time, president, he can declare general emergency by the advice of council of ministers. And when there is breakdown of law and order in a state, the president can take over the administration of that state. The president, he can take over the administration of the state when there is a breakdown of law and order. When there is a breakdown of law and order, a president, he can take over the administration of that state. Okay. And what are the discretionary powers of the governor? And all of you know that the governor is the representative of the union government. Okay. And he has some discretionary powers. The governor can recommend presidents or rule in the state, and the council of ministers loses the confidence of the legislative assembly, and no other party can form a ministry. The governor feels that there is a complete breakdown of law and order in a state. In this situation, the governor, he can recommend a president or rule. What are the two situations? The council of ministers loses the confidence of the legislative assembly, and there is no party can form a ministry. And the second situation is, the governor feels that there is a complete breakdown of law and order. These are the two situations. The governor, he can recommend a president or rule in the state. Okay. And what we have learned in this lesson? We have learned about the official head of central and state. Then we learned about the judicial powers, legislative powers, executive powers, and the emergency powers of the president. And last we discussed about the discretionary powers of the governor. Okay, hope that all of you understood up to here. If you have any doubt about this topic, please comment.